Good morning, students. So first I'm going to start the homework discussion which I gave on 15th. So I've given two questions, exercise 3.2 part 4 sub part K and L. I've done those questions here for you. You can have a look at how I've arranged the data. Again, I'm telling you in this video that you don't need to draw these lines. Am I clear? You don't need to draw these lines. You just have to get an understanding that everything should be aligned properly. That's all. Let's go to the next question here. Now, next topic. So, what is our next topic? Now, I'm going to show you. Now, so far you have done 4-digit numbers addition, but there are only 2 numbers given to you. So, what if 3 numbers are given to you? Yes, the process is the same. The only thing is that you need to be very careful, okay, while aligning and while writing. So, these 2 questions I have done for you. Add the following number. We will be looking into exercise 3.3. Okay. In exercise 3.3 part 1, the first question is the numbers are already arranged for you and you have to add them. Okay. So this is exercise 3.3. In 3.3, all the questions are of 4-digit addition only, but there are 3 numbers here. Okay. So let's look here. So these 2 questions I have done for you. See now here. What we advise you, if there are 3 numbers given to you, okay, you can see here, I'll just show you. So this first one is a 3-digit number, this is a 4-digit and this is a 4-digit. So I prefer that you will do the write the 3-digit number first and then the remaining 4 digits can be written. This will be easy for alignment and it will be easy for your understanding purpose also. So obviously if all the numbers are 4-digit, then you don't have to think which to write first, which to write second. But if either one of them is 3-digit, then it is preferable to write the 3-digit number first so that you will not be confused. Now moving on to some more questions. Okay, part 2 also the questions are the same. 3 numbers are given to you. So you see again here what I have done. I have written the 3-digit number first followed by the 4-digit numbers. Then I have started adding the ones place. This is your carry. Right, and I have done the addition. Keep the spacing properly. If you are using white page or if you are using a rough page, single line notebook, then make sure that the spacing between the numbers is also good. Okay, 7, 6, 5 should not be written closely together. It should not be cramped. Okay, so these 2 questions I suggest that you do in your notebook as well. Sorry, my dear children, I'll just increase the font size here. Yeah, okay. Do these questions in the notebook. These are all part of your classwork. Okay, these 4 questions. Then you are going to do this homework for tomorrow. Okay, for 16th. So this is the homework that I am expecting you to do. Just I'll show you here. Exercise 3.3, part 2, subpart K and L. Let me see. Yes, just 1 second, please. Let me show you these questions in the textbook also. Yeah. So exercise 3.3. This is your exercise 3.3. Okay, and these are the 2 questions that I have given as homework, right? This one and K and L. Okay. So yes, you will be completing this homework. Then I will discuss it in the next class. And yeah, keep revising the old things also that I have taught you, right? Especially Roman numerals. So but the homework is only these 2 questions and complete the classwork also. I hope by now you are already completing all the classwork. The entire textbook, entire chapter is there on the Google Drive now. By now I hope you all know where to access the Google Drive, how to see the PDF of the chapter. Okay, so this PDF of the textbook, I have put all the pages in this one. Okay, and it is uploaded on the Google Drive. I have shown you several times, I have informed you several times. Yeah, so you can use it for your reference. Okay, thank you, students.